Rev up your engines.
Charlie G says, why do most modern American cars have four-cylinder engines these days? Well, that's a very good question. The main reason is because it's cheaper to make four-cylinder engines. They weigh less, so they get better gas mileage because they weigh less, they're smaller, they have to pull their own weight, and they're pulling less weight. But they have a lot more power. Now the average four-cylinder engine has 188.1 horsepower. So these four-cylinder engines today actually have more power than the V8 engines did 20 years ago. Now, of course, everything comes at a cost. If you take a four-cylinder engine and you put in gasoline direct injection with a ton of pressure and put dual turbochargers on it, you're straining the engine more. And of course, if you strain the engine more, it's not going to last as long. So, of course, that kind of goes along with a lot of manufacturers. They don't want their products to last forever. So, if the four-cylinder turbocharged GDI engine wears out faster, then you either got to buy another car or a very expensive engine to put in it. So it kind of fits in with the times. That's the real reason, is that they're cheaper to make, they don't last as long, and they get better gas mileage. So, of course, they're going to be going with four-cylinder engines, plus the cars themselves are getting smaller and smaller, so you don't need a big engine, and a big engine isn't going to fit in them anyways. That's one of the big reasons they went to V6 engines instead of straight six. A V6 engine's shorter, you can fit them in a front-wheel drive vehicle, where a straight six is too long, and it's harder to fit them in a smaller front-wheel drive vehicle. It has to do with size, too. There's no arguing that. Daniel Geraldo, and he says, what's the cheap and good quality synthetic oil? I only drive 5,000 miles per year. Okay, that's a very good question, because synthetic oil, there's all kinds of different types. The rule is that the oil has to be somehow treated synthetically for it to be called synthetic oil. But most of the ones, especially in the United States, are perfectly fine to use. And since you're only driving 5,000 miles a year, you got to change it once a year anyway. Go to Walmart, buy theirs, or down the street from me, the AutoZone. It sells STP synthetic oil, and it's like $5.50 a quart. So what the heck? Use that. It's excellent quality oil. Now the super expensive ones, Mobil 1, Redline, the racing ones, they can last more than 5,000 miles, but they cost so much more, and you got to change it once a year anyway. So just use the regular ones. They're perfectly fine. There's absolutely nothing wrong with using them. You don't have to spend too much money. Truthmaker says, Scotty, do chip-tuned devices work? Well, to some extent, they can work, the really good ones. But realize that's for old style. Years ago, the computers and cars had RAM chips, and there was programmable memory. And you could take them off the computer, and you can put different ones in. And if somebody knew what they were doing, they could put correct ones in for either more horsepower or better gas mileage. Modern cars, the computers are all reprogrammable, the entire computer itself. There's no parts you have to change. So if you're going to mess with a modern car, then you get one of these programmers. And you hope that you know somebody who has a good programmer, knows how to reprogram it to run it the way you want. But the one advantage of those programmers are they almost all have a failsafe. So before you do anything, it says store the original software, and so it'll store the original software. So if you screw something up, you can push a button and it can just get rid of the software you put on and reinstall the original software. All the good ones do that. You mess up, all you got to do is push a button and put the old stuff back on. Cloudstrice says, what do you think of the 1.6 turbo gasoline engine in the Nissan Juke? Okay, I am not a Nissan fan since they merged with Renault almost a couple decades ago. Their quality has been going But Nissan makes decent engines. It's the rest of the vehicles that often break down. The engines are decent engines, but the Juke itself, I just think they look weird. That's a matter of personal taste. I wouldn't be seen dead owning one driving around. I think they look weird. But if you don't mind the way they look, if you are going to buy one, get a standard transmission, because they can run a long time. Nissan makes one of the worst automatic transmissions in the world. It's called Jatco. Nissan used to own all the Jatco. It wasn't even Jatco, it was Nissan. And then they splintered it off from the company and decided to call it Jatco, Japanese Automatic Transmission Co. They make the worst automatic transmissions in the world. I would not buy a car with one of those in it. So if you never want to miss another one of my new car repair videos, remember to ring that bell.